हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम इन जीएस कॉमर्स कॉलेज वर्धा। आई एम प्रोफेसर शैलेश बिसेन एंड आई एम टीचिंग फाइनेंशियल अकाउंटिंग पार्ट टू टू बीकॉम सेकंड ईयर स्टूडेंट्स। नाउ इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैव गिविंग द इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट हाउ टू कीप द फाइनेंशियल रिकॉर्ड ऑफ द कंसाइनमेंट ट्रांजेक्शन बाय कंसाइनर। नाउ इन माय टुडेस वीडियो आई एम गिविंग द इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट हाउ टू कीप इन द फाइनेंशियल रिकॉर्ड ऑफ द ट्रांजेक्शन विच आर डन बाय कंसाइनर and the financial record in the books of consignee. Normally consignee prepare the several accounts for keeping the record all these transactions which are done by itself, but now I just show the account which is compulsory and which is always prepared by the consignee. The account is that consignor's account. The transactions which are done by consignee which are related to consignment, it's recorded in the consignor's account like that. Now the first transaction which is made by consignee is that when consignor make agreement or deal with consignee, at a time consignor send some goods to consignee. For that consignee taking some advance from consignor taking some advance from consignee. So the first transaction which is related to consignee is that consignee paid advance to consignor. This is the first transaction related to consignee. So how to keep in the financial record of this transaction by the consignee? Consignee give the advance to consignor. At a time it passed the journal entry consignor's account debit because amount given to the consignor by consignee, so it's debited the consignor's account because now this transaction consignor is a receiver. So consignee passed the journal entry consignor's account debit because consignee paid the amount to consignor, so it's recorded at the debit side of the consignor's journal entry is that consignor's account debit. And if consignee pay the amount in cash account credited, if consignee give the check to consignor, it means bank account credited, or consignor drop a bill on consignee and consignee accepted that, at that time it will credited the bills payable account because it's payable to the consignor, bills payable to the consignor. So first transaction advance give to the consignor, journal entry for that consignor account debit, cash account credit or bank account credit or bills payable account credit. Okay, advance given to the consignor, so it's right at the debit side of the consignor's account by the name to cash account if it paid the cash for advance, or bank account or bills payable account. It's depend upon which type consignee give the advance to the consignor. Okay, if it give the cash, it created a cash account. If it give the check, post dated check, bank account credit, and if it accepted the bill by consignee, at that time bills payable account credit. This is the first transaction over. Journal entry consignor's account debit, cash account credit or bank account credit or bills payable account credit. Then second transaction, consignor send the goods to consignee, consignee taking the delivery of that goods. For that it have need to spend some expenses which is called as consignee's direct expenses. Consignee's direct expenses, consignee paid direct expenses. For that consignee passed the journal entry, consignee passed the journal entry, all this amount which is paid by consignee in behalf of consignor, consignee paid all expenses for consignor. These are not consignee's expenses, all expenses are paid by consignee on behalf of the consignor. So consignee think that all expenses, all this amount is gone goes for consignor, so it debited the consignor's account. Consignee person will generate it for their expenses which are made for the consignee. Consignor's account debit and if cash goes out, so cash account credit. If it pay the payment digitally, it can create the bank account. Okay, so what is the journal entry for consignee's expenses in the book of consignee? Consignee paid some expenses, for that it passed the journal entry consignor's account debit and cash or bank account credit. Recorded this journal entry in the book of consignor is that 2. Consignor's account debit, so they write a debit side of consignor account by the name cash account or bank. Okay, after that it means when goods are reached at the consignee's godown, it will try to sell the goods. For that it have need to pay some expenses like advertisement expenses, godown rent, salesman's commission, etc., etc. These accounts are, these expenses are also called as consignee's indirect expenses. So now the second transaction of consignee is that consignee sold some goods. What is the journal entry of these transactions which are made by consignee? Consignee sold the goods. Consignee can sold the goods on cash or consignee can sold the goods on credit. Now first we were clear that consignee sold the goods on cash. What is the journal entry for this transaction? Consignee sold the goods on cash. If you sold the goods on cash, at that time you got the cash. It means cash is coming in the hand of consignee. So consignee passing journal entry cash account debit. It can also pass the bank account debit, no problem. Cash or bank account debit. And all this amount which is consignee collected by selling the goods, all amount is payable to the consignor. Because these goods are the consignor's goods. So all the amount which consignee got by selling goods, this total amount is payable to the consignor. So cash is coming, but the liability is created. This amount is due to the consignor, payable to the consignor. So consignee pass entry cash or bank account debit and consignor's account credit. Journal entry cash or bank account debit and consignor's account credit. So write at the credit side of consignor account by the name cash or bank account. Okay, this is for cash sales. This is just for you for understanding cash or bank account. Okay, consignee sold the goods on cash, at that time it passed the journal entry cash or bank account debit and consignor's account credit, because all this amount is payable to the consignor. Then when consignee sold the goods on credit. When who is selling the goods on credit, at that time they created the debtors. The person to whom we sold the goods on credit basis, these are called as debtors. Then consignee sold the goods on credit, at that time it's created the debtors. And all this amount which due from debtors, due to consignor. It means it sold the goods on credit. For that he have need to due some amount from its debtors. And the amount which it will be collected in future from these debtors, all payable to the consignor. Because the goods, the ownership of goods of consignor, these are the consignor's goods, we just send to consignee for solding. So the amount which is due from debtors are payable to consignor. The journal entry for selling the goods on credit. When consignee sold the goods on credit, at that time it will pass the journal entry debtor's account debit and consignor's account credit. Debtor's account debit and consignor's account credit. If it won't create the debtor's account, sending debtor's account. Sending debtor's account. If it won't show the debtor's, normally the debtor's account never created because there are no any account prepared by any common name. All the person accounts are prepared by their proper names. But now we don't know who is consignee sent to goods to whom, we don't know. So we using the common noun, debtors account. There are several accounts, but we show the just picture of group of all debtors account. So when consignee sold the goods on credit, at that time it debited the debtors account and credited the consignor's account. How to write it entry in the ledger book? At the debit side of selling debtors account to consignor's account. This is the credit sales. Amount due from selling debtors, so debited the selling debtors account. And it will return at the credit side of consignor's account because this amount due to the consignor by the name of sundry debtors account. Sundry debtors account. This is for credit sale. Credit sales. There is no need to write it, but I just written there for you can understand that. This is the entry for cash sales. This is the entry for credit sales. Once again, if consignee sold goods on cash, at that time cash or bank account debit and consignor's account credit. And it sold goods on credit, at that time sundry debtors account debit and debtor consignor's account credit. Okay, consignor's account credit. For the selling the goods, consignee spent some expenses, which called as consignee's indirect expenses. For selling the goods, consignee have need to spend some expenses like advertisement, godown rent, carriage outward, then salesman's commission, all these expenses. Consignee spent some expenses. For that, consignee passed the journal entry. All these expenses it done for in favor of consignor. So once again, consignor's account debit. Because all these expenses are which are made by itself are decreasing the amount, decreasing the due amount which is payable to the consignor. Now credit side of consignor account, it shows the amount which is payable to consignor. And all the amounts which spent for consignment are recorded at the debit side because it's decreasing the payable amount. It deducted from the payable amount. So all these expenses, all the transactions which are deducting the decreasing the amount due to the consignor, right at the debit side of consignor account. So consignee spent expenses for consignment, it's debited the consignor's account. And for the making these expenses, the cash is goes out from the consignee. So consignee credited the cash or bank account. General entry for that, consignor's account debit and cash or bank account credit. So debit side of the consignor's account write by the name of cash or bank account. You think about that, sir, the same entry had passed at a two time. When he spent the expenses, direct expenses, and it spent the indirect expenses. The general entry has same. But why you repeated that? Because now in my first video, which have given the information about total consignment and consignee's expenses. In this video, I have given information, consignee's expenses are classified into two types. First is consignee's direct expenses and consignee's indirect expenses. Because if at the end of financial year or at the end of consignment there have some unsold stock, we have need to evaluate this unsold stock.
at the time of valuation of unsold stock, all the direct expenses of consignee are considered in the value of unsold stock. But all these expenses which consignee made for selling the goods, which we call consignee's indirect expenses, are never included in the value of unsold stock. So I am giving this entry at a two time. First time, these are the direct expenses, and after that these are the indirect expenses, because direct expenses are included in the value of unsold stock and indirect expenses are never included in the value of unsold stock. So for the clarity, I am giving two generalities, first for direct expenses and second for indirect expenses. And normally it's a reality is that when it's take the delivery of goods, it you need to pay some expenses. At that time it passed the general entry, consignors account debit and cash on bank account credit. And when it's trying to selling the goods, at that time it need to pay some expenses. For that, at the time of making expenses, it will pass the general entry, consignors account debit and cash on bank account credit. Understood? So consignee have sold the goods on cash and sold the goods on credit, and it's given the advance amount to consignor, it's paid direct expenses, it's paid indirect expenses, okay, over these transactions. Then consignee have sold the goods. Now consignee have sold the goods on cash basis or credit basis. After that, when consignee sold the goods, consignee charge its commission, because consignee is entitled on the commission basis. The deal between consignor and consignee is that consignee sold the goods and taking its commission, which is done at the time of agreement between the consignor and consignee. Okay, so consignee have sold the goods, so it's charged its commission. Consignee charge itself commission for selling the goods as per their deal, as per their agreement. Okay, so what is the general entry for commission? Entry for that is that all the amount which is payable to consignor written at the credit side of consignor's account. So when consignee charge its commission, this amount is decreasing the amount which is payable to the consignor. So all these transactions which are decreasing the amount due to consignor are recorded at the debit side of the consignor. So now for self commission, consignee pass the general entry, consignor's account debit, and commission is its consignee's income, and all incomes are credited. So consignee passing journal entry, consignor's account debit and commission account credit. It can say receive commission account credit. If you want, you can prepare the account. Consignee always prepare this account. It's their book. Commission account or receive commission account. It's self-commission, consignee's commission. Entry, consignor account debit, receive commission account credit. At the debit side of consignor account, write by the name of receive commission. You can say only commission. Commission account. And at the credit side of receive commission account, write by the name of consignor's account. Consignors. Okay, this is a general entry. Now normally I said to you how to calculating the consignee's commission, which there have the three types of consignee's commission. All the information about commission and how to charge the commission, I will give the information about that in my next video. Now how to calculate the normal loss, abnormal loss and type of commissions, giving the information in next video. Now just we taking the information how to record the transactions which are done by the consignee in its book. it charge its commission. For that it passes the other entry, consignor's account debit and receive commission account credit, because it's the its consignor's income and all income are credited at their income's account. Then if they have some goods which are not compatible for sale or which don't have any demand, these goods are returned by consignee to the consignor. So the transaction may be consignee return the goods to consignor. Consignee return the goods to consignor. At a time, the entry, once again, goods return. The entry never passed by consignee. Because when goods taken from consignor, it never entry had not passed because this is no making no any transaction. So when consignee return the goods to consignor, consignee never passed the journal entry. Consignor passing journal entry because when it sent the goods to consignee, passed the journal entry. So it had need to, when it get return goods from consignee, it have need to pass the journal entry in the book of consignor. But consignee, when it take the delivery of goods, it never pass journal entry because the goods are just transferred from consignor to consignee. The goods are never purchased by consignee, so it not passing the journal entry. Okay. If next transaction, if consignee want take some goods for itself, if for its business or for its personal use, consignee taking some goods which are sent by consignor for on consignment basis, out of these goods consignee taking some goods for itself, the entry for that, the goods which are taken by consignee, calculated the amount of that goods and this amount is payable to the creditor, to the consignor. So it pass the journal entry, purchase account debit, pass the journal entry, purchase account debit, because the goods are purchased by consignee, so it pass entry purchase account debit and all this amount is due to the consignor, so consignor's account credit. By purchase account goods for sale, we don't know about that. It's taken the goods for self use or it's taken the goods for its business, we don't know. Okay, we just know that it's taken the goods. Okay, so it's passing journal entry, purchase account debit and amount due to consignor, so consignor account credit. Then charge commission, expenses paid. Okay, the transaction. Then if it had, it means consignee had sold the goods on credit, at that time it have been to make a recovery from the debtors, so it collected the amount from debtors. It means consignee collected the amount from debtors. At that time it passed the journal entry. Cash is coming. Some debtors are paid the amount by check. So cash account debit or bank account debit and debtors account credit. The journal entry for collecting the amount from debtors is that cash or bank account debit and debtors and debtors account credit. So right at the credit side. Bye. Cash or bank account, cash or bank, by the name of cash or bank account. This amount is for the consignor, but now this time it never credited the consignor's account, because when consignee sold the goods on credit, at that time it's credited the consignor's account. It means the amount due is already written at the credit side of consignor's account. So once again, it cannot write the amount which gotten by him. It never write at the credit side. Okay? The amount due, when it sold the credit sales, at that time, it passed the journal entry, creditor's account debit and consignor's account credit. So now when it getting cash from debtors, at that time it passing the journal entry cash or bank account debit and certificate account credit. But now
we bitterly know that when sold selling the goods on credit, at that time they're making some, there had been done some bad debts. We normally can't get full amount from there, from our debtors. There will be some bad debts. So they have some bad debts because due amount is higher than the receipt amount. It means some amount we lost. It's known as bad debts. The amount which we cannot recover from debtors. Not recover onward, and it will never recover in future. It's known as bad debts. The amount have lost. It's called as bad debts. So it's the most important role of bad debts in consignment. If consignor allow the day creditor commission, second type of commission is that day creditor commission. If consignor due the allowed to the consignee as a day creditor commission, at that time the bad debts, it's a consignee's expenses. Okay? And if consignor never allowed day creditor commission to consign, at that time the amount which making back, it's a consignor's loss. Okay? So as per that, bad debts, what is the general entry made by consignee? It's depend on the if they have allowed day creditor commission or not. If their day creditor commission is allowed, if consignor have allowed the day creditor commission to consign, general entry of bad debt is that consignor's accounting, they have allowed day creditor commission. Okay, repeat my sentence. If consignor allowed the day creditor commission to consign, at that time general entry in the book of consignee is that bad debt account debit, because it's itself loss, because there have day creditor commission is allowed given by the consignor. When day creditor commission has allowed by consignor, at that time the bad debts, it's a consignee's own loss. So it passing general entry bad debt, either bad debt account debit, or it deducted the its income. So it can write the receive commission account. It depends upon yourself. You can debit a bad debts account or you can debit a receive commission account. It means you got the commission from consignment, and the bad debts is deducting your commission, your income. So you can already deduct that loss from this income. Once again, commission is your income which you get from this consignment, and the bad debts is one loss which you got from this consignment. Okay, which you suffer from this consignment. So if there are commission is your income and bad debts is your loss, both things are related to the consignment. So you think from this loss deducted from this income, so you can debit at the receive commission account. Understood that the loss deducted from receive commission or it's separately written at the debit side of the bad debts account. Okay, so consignee passes general entry for bad debts. Once again, clearly, if there have day creditor commission is given by consignor to consignee, at that time journal entry for bad debts is that bad debts account debit or receive commission account debit and debtors account credit. Okay, so you can debit it at the bad debts account. To debtors account. Okay, and general entry, now for this picture, bad debts account debit and sundry debtors account credit. bank bank debts account. Okay, the account of debtors, debtors account. Okay, close the account. At the time when there are debt relief commission is allowed, the general entry for bank debt is that bank debts account debit, debtors account credit. Okay, and this entry had never passed by the consignee. If their debt relief commission is allowed given to the consignee, at that time the entry for bank debts had never passed by the consignee. Okay, but if this debt creditor commission is not given by consignor to the consignee, it means there is no debt creditor commission allowed to the consignee and there have bad debts. Okay, what is the general entry passed by consignee for bad debts? If debt creditor commission is allowed, consignee pass general entry, bad debts account debit, debtors account credit. But if debt creditor commission is not given, at that time the bad debts is being considered as loss. Debt creditor commission is not allowed, at that time the bad debts is considered the consignor's loss. So this loss is decreasing the amount which is payable to the consignor. So and all the transactions which decreasing the payable amount are recorded at the debit side of consignor account. Okay, and bad debts at the time of debt creditor commission is not given, the bad debts is a consignor's loss, so it's recorded at the debit side of consignor account. So general entry for that, consignor account debit and their sundry debtor account credit. So write at the debit side of the consignor account by the name of consignor account debit, sundry debtors account credit. Sundry debtors account, it's a bad debts. Okay, sundry debtors account. Okay, and now there by consignors, I just give the amount at one time because both transactions are not made at a time. If there have debt creditor commission is allowed, consignor pass debtor entry, bad debts account debit and sundry debtors account credit. Because now there, when debt creditor commission allowed to consignee, at that time bad debts is itself loss. It's itself loss. When if debt creditor commission, debt creditor commission is given, if debt creditor commission is given, at that time bad debts is the consignee's own loss. So he is passing the general entry, bad debts account debit and sundry debtors account credit. But the debt creditor commission is not given to consignee, at that time the bad debts is a consignor's expenses, consignor's loss. It's a consignor's loss. So it's deducted the amount which is payable to the consignor. Now when we write any transaction at the debit side of consignor account, it means we didn't take the amount which is due to the consignor, which have been payable to the consignor. Okay, we want deducting that amount, we have need to write at the debit side of the consignor's account. So general entry for that, consignor's account debit and sundry debtors account credit. Is that clear? If there have bad debts, you firstly check it. In this example, there have debt creditor commission or not. It means their debt creditor commission is given to given by consignor to consignee or not. If they have given the debt creditor commission, the bad debts, it's a consignee's own loss. So it's passing general entry, bank debits account debit, and sundry debtors account debit. And there have no any debit or commission given to the consignee. At that time, consignor's account debit and sundry debtors account credit. Out of this transaction, we are discussing in the book of consignor about this transaction. If now in the book of consignor, okay, if there are bad debts, but there have debt reader commission is given to the consignee, the entry of bad debts had never passed by the consignee. But if there is a bad debts when debt reader commission is not given to the consignee, the general entry in the book of consignor is that it's a consignment loss. So if passing general entry, consignor passing general entry, consignment account debit and consignee's account credit. Okay, so coming to the book of consignee, cash collected from debtors. If consignee pays some amount to consignor in at the end of consignment or during the consignment, if like given the advance like that, if consignee gives some amount to consignor at that time, consignee passing entry, consignor's account debit and cash or bank account credit. When consignee gives some amount to consignor like advance amount, okay, but at one time it's give the advance, but after that when he sold the goods or it get recovery from the debtors, it have need to pay some amount to the consignor. So whenever it gives some amount to consignor, it will passing general entry, consignor's account debit and cash or bank account credit. So right at the debit side of consignor, cash or bank account. Okay, this is advance given by consignee to the consignor. It is that consignor account debit, cash or bank account credit. Cash or bank is depend upon the transaction. If consignor give the payment in cash form, so it credited the cash account. If consignee making this transaction through the bank digital payment, at a time it's credited the bank account. Okay, return the goods, stick on the goods, the transaction over. After that, at the end of financial year, consignee making the balancing process and disclose the consignor's account. If there is a ending of consignment, at that time consignee give the total amount to the consignor, or the transaction of consignment is continuous, run continuously, but they have the end the financial year, they have need to find out the final balance amount. If there is no balance, it cannot take balance, but if they have balance, it's right. All this due amount is written at the credit side, and all the amount which paid or spent for consignor are recorded at the debit side. So making the total of both side and decreasing the amount which is low from highest amount and find out the balance. Normally due amount is higher than the more than the amount paid. So normally this account show the debit balance. If there is a over the consignment, then it will never show the balance. If all amount which got or payable from consignee paid total amount, then the account never show the balance. But the consignee have some amount due to consignor, it show the balance. If there have some balance carry the balance which have on the person's account, it's carry doubt for next year. Okay, so consignor's account is completed. Then sundry debtors account also goes receive commission account, and if they have bank debts account, you have two options. If you want close the bank debts account by transferring this amount to receive commission account, it can transfer the this balance transfer to the receive commission account, or it can you can transfer this amount to the P&L account. It's depend upon you. Okay, the bad debts you can deduct it from the receive commission account, or it's transferred to the P&L account. If you transfer this amount right there to bad debts account, okay, after that when you getting the balancing process, this amount is known as balance, and balance of all nominal accounts at the end of financial year, when you getting the balancing process, at that time you never keep the balance on the nominal accounts. It means all the accounts of expenses, losses and incomes and gains, all the accounts are just prepared for one financial year. So never keep the balance on their accounts. All the accounts are closed and the balance on there are transferred to the some trading account or P&L account. Okay, they never keep the balance. So it's balance transfer to P&L account. After that, total will be same. This account will be closed. Okay, if you're doing this process like that, the account closed. Or now in P&L account, this amount goes as the credit side of P&L account. When consigning under their final account at that time, this amount goes at the credit side. Okay, never no any amount go for P&L account, because this amount transferred to there. But if you credited by the name of P&L account, if you have transferred this amount to P&L account at that time, the balance show this account is like that. You got this balance. It's come at the credit side of P&L account and it's gone at the debit side of P&L account. It means it's increasing the profit income and it's decreasing the income. Okay, the effect may be same. So it's depend upon you. You at the time of bad debts, you can debit it to receive commission account, never prepare the bad debts account, or you prepare the bad debts account at the end of financial year, transfer this amount to the receive commission account, or if keeping separate balance of receive commission account and bad debts account and transfer both balance to the P&L account. Okay, understood that? If you don't understood for this information, you don't worry about that. You just keeping the financial entries for the transactions which are related to the consignment. Okay, and normally you don't need to show the consignor's account. Firstly, overview of this all transactions. Now, the first transaction generally making 75 examples is that consignee give the advance to the consignor. For that, consignor's account debit, cash account credit or bank account credit or bills payable account credit if it accepted the bill. After that, if consignee spent some expenses, generally consignor's account debit, cash or bank account credit. Once again, consignor spent indirect expenses, both same entries, consignor account debit and cash or bank account credit. If consignee sold goods on cash, entry, cash or bank account debit, consignor account credit. If consignee sold goods on credit, sundry debtors account debit, which you show or not, but entry, same. Sundry debtors account debit, consignor account credit. Consignee charge its commission, entry, consignor account debit, issue commission account credit. Okay, then it got some amount from from sundry debtors, consignee passive entry, cash or bank account debit, sundry debtors account credit. If they have bad debts, it's depend upon two situations. If debt creditor commission is given, entry, bad debts or receive commission account debit, sundry debtors account credit, which you want. But if they have debt creditor commission is not given, if debt creditor commission is given, receive commission or bad debts account debit, sundry debtor account credit.
But death creditor commission is not allowed. Death creditor commission is not given by consignor to consignee at that time. Entry is that consignor's account debits and debtor's account credit. Okay. Lastly, if the sum amount paid by consignee to consignor, entry consignor's account debit and cash or bank account credit. Okay. And making the balancing process, if they have some balance, keep it. But if they give settle their account by paying bank draft, demand draft, anyway information is given, so don't show the balance. This is will be your last entry. Okay. All this information is related to the consignment and how to keeping the financial record related to the transactions by consigning. I have given the information about that in this my lecture. Now in next video, I am giving the information about how to calculate the commission. Okay, what is the meaning of commission, kinds of commission, and how to calculate the amount of commission. Also, we have need to know the valuation of unsold stock. We are also taking the information about what is the normal loss and abnormal loss. Okay, today's class is over. Thank you so much. Bye.